My name is Ethel Cofie. I am a tech entrepreneur from Ghana. I run Women in Tech Ghana, and I'm a founding member of the Women in Tech Africa Alliance.
Important, but that should be saved for a business plan, right? Which they will read after, okay? And as I mentioned earlier, include your branding throughout the entire deck, right? We don't want to forget who you are. Don't want to forget what your branding looks like, what your product name is.
Yeah.
Inspire us with their perseverance. There are entrepreneurs like Ethel Cofie, who is here today. I met Ethel this past May at the Meltwater Entrepreneurial School of Technology, a dynamic incubator in Accra, Ghana. Ethel runs a successful technology consulting firm that specializes in many fields, including mobile app and software development. But her success did not come easily. Ethel grew up in Accra. She was one of only four women in a class of 150 to graduate from Ghana's Valley View University, earning a degree in computer science. She won a scholarship to attend graduate school in London, then returned home to Ghana to pursue her dream and start her business. However, Ethel could not find enough clients for her consulting firm. She could not secure enough business or support. She ran into too many obstacles, and she had to close down her operations. Ethel's original company failed, but all was not lost. In the following years, she worked for the Gates Foundation on a project to expand mobile technology in Ghana. She served as a technical consultant to the Ford Foundation initiative on election monitoring in Nigeria. She managed a team of technical and business analysts for Vodafone. Through these experiences, Ethel learned and decided to try again, this time with mentorship from her father, her former boss at Vodafone, and one of the leading digital media entrepreneurs in Ghana. Ethel succeeded, and today her business is thriving. Now she wants other women, especially in the tech sector, to follow her lead. In fact, this summer, Ethel organized an online Pan-African meetup to exchange best practices and encourage fellow women tech entrepreneurs across the continent.
Good afternoon, everybody. Am I on? My name is Lamre Akinola. I'm the editor of This is Africa at the Financial Times. The question is, what inspired me to change the world? Tales of challenge and innovation. And we're going to get firsthand accounts from innovators who are putting groundbreaking solutions out there that are redefining the global economy, redefining what it means to do business in the 21st century. And what we're going to try to do is get a practical sense of what it means to be an innovator and how and why it is important to leverage innovation to not only change the way we do business, but also to help develop communities. Those are the themes we're going to explore. Allow me to very quickly introduce our speakers before we go into the questions. To my immediate left is Ethel Cofie, who is the founder of Edel Technologies.
I don't think I woke up one day and thought I wanted to change the world, so I might not have the right answer for you there. But I will say that I have three passions, and that's technology, entrepreneurship, and women leadership. And I run my company, Edel, and we work with businesses and the big nonprofits to use technology to enable them to solve the problems they have in business. So strategy and technology to be able to help businesses win. I also run an accelerator that helps startups scale in multiple markets. Again, it's about growing the African brand and growing multinational African companies. So I think it's, for me, it's very much about I saw a problem, I wanted to solve it. I didn't know whether it's going to change the world or whether it's changing the world, but I saw a problem and I wanted to solve it.
You also run an accelerator as well as Edel Technologies, but give us a bit of a sense of where the community aspect fits in here and why that matters to you.
Well, so for me, as I alluded to before, that the idea that we have very few truly multinational original African companies is something that bothered me. Now, it's wonderful to run a business and make a profit and buy a car for your family and pay your bills and take care of just your family and pay two or three people that you work with. But how much more impact will you have on your community? And if you are employing hundreds, 300s, that you have enough money to spend on as a company on CSR initiatives that will build up your community. So this is where we're coming from. So for us, it's helping the most scalable products and ideas from Africa to truly grow. And in that, bringing along not only families and not just being a micro company.
We all intuitively understand that innovation is important to, you know, to reform markets, to evolve markets. But intangible in terms, what are we talking about here? Ethel, back to you now. Your company is called Edel Technologies and Consulting. Now, consulting is a fairly established business, but you're doing it differently, right? How are you doing it differently and why? And what's the sort of bigger picture around a new approach and different approach to a service like this?
Also, we at Edel truly believe that technology is an enabler. So technology gives you the tools to take you from point A to point B. With the for-profits or for the business organizations we work with, we want to come in and come in as a partner. We want to sit with that client and understand where they want to go, what their strategy is, what do they want to achieve as a business. And then we will look at how they work, what their processes are, how they work, and then begin to see the places where technology can become an enabler. So I'll give you an example. So you have a brand that says, a manufacturer, and they say, well, we've got so much trouble with the finance, the receipt goes to the finance department and it's missing and we can't find the links. And sitting with them and understanding what strategically where they're going in the next year, in the next 12 months, in the next 5 years, and building them almost a platform to enable all the different departments to be able to connect and flow, so that as a CEO, the CEO of the company can sit in his office and understand what's happening in his business. So it's not there is a tool, it's exciting and we're going to plug it in, but it is we want to support you to get to where you need to get to as a business. And that could mean that we do you something as low denominational as an SMS campaign, because your customers, you reach your customers via SMS.
or it would be something as grand as a customer relationship management system that touches all the touch points of your company. Mm-hmm. But it is, again, coming in from a strategic point and looking at ways that technology enables and adds value rather than just building up, you know, interesting tech.
Really. So going beyond tweeting for the sake of tweeting.
Yes.
And leveraging technology for genuine strategic value.
Yes.
And do you, in terms of the scalability of this, is this the way of the future? Is this a growth industry?
Yeah, so I think that at the end of the day, technology that is appropriate mm-hmm. is the technology that wins out. Yes. And this is very scalable. We're seeing this happen, you know, all over the world. We're seeing that it's not I have an accounting system because I need an accounting system. And sometimes I will tell a client, Excel works for you and it's fine.
Yeah.
And at this point and where you are, use Excel.
Great, thank you, Ethel.